This morning, our focus is on divorce and new beginnings. My colleague Tamsin Fidel talking candidly about her breakup and the road back in her new book, The New Single. Now I'm extremely pleased to be joined by Avery Korman. Avery is the award-winning author of a book that had an incredible social impact once it was turned into a motion picture, Kramer versus Kramer, starring Dustin Hoffman and Meryl Streep. It won 5 Oscars, including Best Picture, some 36 years ago.
I just got to call the office before they go. Joe, you're going to be real proud of me.
I'm leaving you.
What's this, some kind of joke? Did you know that all the best chefs are men?
You got some shell in there.
Oh, that's all right. You like your French toast crunchy, don't you?
No, Mommy always buys the kind with the orange circles on it.
I want my son.
You can't have him.
What makes you so sure he doesn't want me?
I'm not that late, though. I'm only 20 minutes.
All the other mothers were there before you.
It will never happen again, okay?
I'm not saying he doesn't need his father, but I really believe he needs me more than his mother.
My wife says that she loves Billy, and I believe she does, but I'd like to know, what law is it that says that a woman is a better parent simply by virtue of her sex?
Wow.
How does it feel?
Good.
Okay, keep going.
Keep it going!
That's terrific!
I love you, Billy.
Oh, that's terrific! How do you feel?
Good!
You look great!
Kramer versus Kramer, the iconic movie of the divorce revolution of the period of 1979. Avery Korman, so good to have you with us today. And he's also the author of a new book called My Old Neighborhood Remembered. It is a memoir of growing up in the Bronx in the 1940s and 1950s. And before I ask you the first question, Avery, I also want to introduce Vicki Ziegler. Vicki is a practicing attorney of matrimonial law and a television personality featured on Bravo, Untying the Knot. She's also the innovator of a unique and realistic approach to divorce management. We'll hear more about that in a moment. But Avery, I have to ask you first, why did Kramer versus Kramer become such a social phenomenon 36 years ago?
Well, I think we were ready for it. If you can put your mind back, those of us who are old enough, there was a lot of crisis going on between men and women at the time. The women's movement was in full blast. There was a lot of anger directed toward men and male institutions appropriately, and I would say excessively. And what happened here is you got to see a guy in a different situation, and it was electric. It just took off, and I think it was a combination, I'd like to say, of the material and the time. It was a perfect storm in a sense, and it just caught.
But up until that time, from the 30s to the 60s, there was some kind of a Hays Code, I guess he was a member of Congress, that forbade any films with a bad ending or any mention, rarely if ever, mention of divorce in a motion picture.
That's right. Well, we finally got out of that. Certainly the 60s busted us out of a lot of conventions that were going on in Hollywood for a long time. So when you get to 1979 for this movie, we're free and clear.
But times have changed between Kramer versus Kramer and the new single, the book that Tamsin has written, and you have seen it legally in the courts. I mean, your film and book focuses on parental custody. In this case, back in 1979, the courts awarded custody to the mother, even though she had abandoned her child and her husband.
Oh, absolutely. Avery was onto something very early on. And I've been practicing for 16 years, but my parents went through this terrible divorce, and I was asked by a judge, who should I live with? And I recommended, and this was in the early 80s, if you don't give me joint shared custody with both of my parents, you're going to have a problem. And I said to the judge, you have the robe, I don't. But let me tell you, if you don't make that recommendation and make them live within a short radius, it's going to be a tough custody battle. And I was 11 at the time. So I can tell you, Avery, 1979 is a very interesting year. It's the first year that California signed a joint custody statute on the books. So, I mean, I don't know if that was fortuitous or foreshadowing, certainly.
Coincidental.
I would think so. And let me tell you, fast forward into 1990, then 40 states adopted a joint custody statute. Now, over the last 20 years, I can tell you that men are getting custody as probably on an equal basis, 1 out of 2 times. And I know when you wrote this this amazing movie, this novel, Kramer versus Kramer, you would have never possibly envisioned those statistics being so high. Now it is commonplace. Women are working, they're the breadwinners, men do stay home, and it really is a gender-neutral statute. We do have challenges throughout the country, depending on where you live, that mothers may get some deference, but generally speaking, I have to be honest, we see all the time who is the best parent and what's the best interest of the child.
It was 90 to 10 in those years.
Yeah, and now I would say it's
90 to 10 for the woman.
Of course. Now it's, I would say it's about 60-40 to the woman.
But also there were changes then. I mean, between then, we're looking back at the book you wrote and the book that Tamsin wrote, you know, talking about modern day breakups. Back then, you needed the fault for a divorce. We have no fault divorce.
Yeah, absolutely, a different story. And also in terms of how we go about the divorce, you know, I went through mediation. Mm-hmm. And I know Vicki and I've talked about this before, and it was just a lot more civil, easy, cleaner. Mm-hmm. There were two people across the table, and obviously children were not involved in my case. But when we're talking about going through mediation and something, you know, Vicki seeing day in and day out, it just seems like that is becoming much more commonplace, don't you think?
100%.
Cleaner across the board when you're dealing with men and women and careers. And, you know, people coming together with a lot more assets.
Yeah, I mean, I think the way you did and resolved your divorce is really the way that most people should. You're in a room. It's not as tense. You know, you don't have a judge who hears all these cases all day long. You have a mediator who's usually either a retired judge or an attorney like myself in a room reading papers in advance and trying to help a couple resolve their issues, divorce with dignity, and move on. And that's exactly actually what my show is about on Bravo. It's called Untying the Knot, and that's what I do. Literally, I meet couples, and I try to help them get divorced. And you know what? It's pain. It's a little less painful.
It's civil. That's the,
civil.
I think most of the time.
And you're saving
civil.
Money.
You save a lot of money with
that's
that.
That's a good point.
No question about it. And I think that I feel like anyway things are going in that direction across the board because I think that in a lot of ways people have come together and they realize what they have before they go into it now instead of just going into it blindly into a marriage.
Incidentally, there was no mediation then either.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
That's a concept that did not exist at the time of Kramer versus Kramer.
And I would say every state in this country has a mediation program whereby you must attend some type of economic mediation throughout your divorce process. And I think it's being mandatory and ensuring that you have an individual, unbiased third party helping you. You're in the thick of things and you really want the best for both parties is really the way to go. I love to mediate cases. I much prefer it than litigating. And I just think you can get better results with people because we're all human and we can sit down at a table in a closed room environment, not in a courtroom that's public.
I think social attitudes, public's attitude toward divorce have changed greatly. Mm-hmm. I want to pursue something. Tamsin's book mirrors her own experience. Mm-hmm. Your book was a novel, which means it was fiction. I want to find out when we come back if that mirrored any part of your own life. Stay with us as Pix 11 News Close Up continues.